Jay Briscoe and Beat Wrestling Spinners Tag Team here at Showdown in the Sun. Wait a minute. Hey, dirt there from Benjamin from behind. A sneak attack after the Briscoe's win.
Oh!
Out on his hands and knees. How he's able to move is beyond me, Kevin.
I don't know if he is going to be able to walk out. Jay Briscoe winds up getting carried out here in Fort Lauderdale.
This is a team on the rise without any doubt.
Let's go to Bobby Cruz.
This tag team match is a proving ground match, except for one fall. In the ring at a combined weight of 405 pounds, the team of Cedric, Alexander, and Caprice, Coleman.
Talked with Coleman and Alexander earlier today. They are wound up tighter than a drum, Nigel, because they know this is their opportunity.
God, boy.
Them boys, Jack Daniels violence, call them what you want, but you better call them champions. And of course, you mentioned it before now, while Jay obviously isn't 100%, he's got no time to rest, because right here today, the Briscoes have to try and stop Coleman and Alexander before they deal with wrestling's greatest tag team.
Sir Curtis, wrestling out of Sandy Fork, Delaware, at a combined weight of 463 pounds, they are the Ring of Honor World Tag Team Champions, Jay and Mark, the Briscoes!
Right now, let's go to the tail of the tape, where you can see Coleman the Elder Statesman, but the seven-time champs with a huge experience advantage. Slight weight edge for the boys from Sandy Fork. Coleman and Alexander adhere to the code of honor. Briscoes aren't thinking about shaking hands. Hey, no offense, Cedric and Caprice.
None taken, I'm sure. Cedric, Caprice, they're hardworking guys. They don't care about shaking hands at the end of the day. They know they can get the job done.
Yep, and they're not going to do it. Nope. It's a focused Briscoes. Tried talking to them earlier today, and normally you get some comments out of the Briscoes. Today, they were having none of it. And I think they are going to look to go straight away here and put Coleman and Alexander down. All the focus, though, on Border Wars for them. May 12th in Toronto, Fight Without Honor for the tag team titles against Haas and Benjamin, and perhaps there is no other way to settle it.
Like Tracy Smells used to say, if you can't get along, you got to get it on, and that's the truth.
So Mark sends Cedric Alexander. Look at the athleticism by Alexander on display, and the quickness, and turns him inside out.
Mexican head scissors, yeah, very nice.
Chopping the blocks out, follows up, leg hooked, only a one.
If Coleman and Alexander score a win here, they earn a future World Tag Team title shot, regardless of whoever the champions are, ladies and gentlemen. And that very well could be Haas and Benjamin if they have their way at Border Wars, but we will wait and see. There's so much going on here in Ring of Honor right now as Jay is tagged in. We do want to welcome our new fans joining us in Albany on the CW15. We want to say hi to Vince, the general manager, and welcome all the great fans from the state capital in New York. Tag now made, and Mark is going to look to come in.
There's a face only a mother could love. You ever see Mark smile at you? It looks like his tongue's in jail.
So it was the best of times, the worst of times for the Briscoes.
A tale of two cities indeed, absolutely. Yeah. You know, obviously, the Briscoes retained the titles against Haas and Benjamin, but Haas and Benjamin retained Jay's trouser chestnuts against the ring post.
And again, now
there we go.
Alexander in to make the tag. Dropkick both of them. Caprice Coleman caught them both. Leg drop there. You saw the spring in his step. There's a move he calls the Blessed T.O. from the ordained minister. The leg is hooked in a two count. Todd Sinclair in position. You know, and you look at the injury that was suffered by Jay, and it's not one of those injuries that's going to put you on the injured list, but it's more of that, how it affects your home life, how it affects when you go home to your wife, and how you're able to have relationships with her. That's what Jay has been dealing with, and that's how personal things have gotten between Haas and Benjamin and the Briscoes.
I mean, you hit the nail on the head there. You know, what we see as wrestling fans is the 15, 20 minutes in the ring. What you don't see is the rest of the week, and that's what really, you know, when you get in the ring, what's happened to you in the prior week is what really puts you intact for it.
Full slam now. Mark's the legal man. Look at this.
What on earth?
I love it. Cover two. Hey, how about Roderick Strong, the new World Television Champion? We saw that last week from Road Rage down at Showdown in the Sun to win over Jay Lethal, making his first title defense here this week against the red-hot Adam Cole. Breakout star of 2012. Maybe the only guy in that category other than Cole would be Michael Elgin, who, my goodness, Nigel, people still are talking about that title match at Showdown in the Sun against Davey Richards.
Yeah, you know, I can't remember a time in Ring of Honor, certainly since I've been back here commentating, that so many people have been talking about one match and one person.
Out of the way. Alexander now tagged in. He flies and skies, knocks him down. Going right after Big Brother Jay now. You have to wonder what Roderick Strong thinks about Elgin's path to success. Certainly he's on the front page of a lot of publications throughout the wrestling world. And I know our good friends at Fighting Spirit Magazine are probably writing about him as well. Oh, wipeout and see ya. Facebuster. Could this be? Might be.
Oh, so close.
Half a count away from a win here in the Proving Ground and a future World Tag Team title shot. Around the post and... Wait a minute. Caprice just got caught. Wheelbarrow right into the barricade. Mark now focusing on Cedric Alexander.
There it is, neck breaker out of the razor's edge.
One, two, no.
Oh.
Don't forget, fans, the Man Beast Rhino makes his ROH television debut later on in the hour. Who will be the target for the Master of the Gore as the Duperns Arena comes alive with the sounds of mana? Now going to the top, all the way to the top. Superplex, perhaps. Alexander just shoves Jay down. All the way to the floor. Wait a minute.
Wait a second. From there.
Look at this. We can see it. Low blow. Haas and Benjamin just struck with a low blow on the Briscoes. Nobody in the ring saw what just happened, Nigel. And they sneak away like thieves in the night. The damage has been done by wrestling's greatest tag team once again. Jay Briscoe is absolutely wiped out from another low blow from wrestling's greatest tag team. But Mark, now having to go it alone. No hand, Hurricanrana.
Mark's in a lot of trouble now. Oh!
One, two, got it!
Unbelievable!
team of Cedric, Alexander, and Caprice, Coleman.
And with that win, Cedric Alexander and Caprice Coleman have earned a future World Tag Team title opportunity. They beat the Briscoes here in the Proving Ground. You can only say that that's a huge upset. We got to take a look, though. We had some fun and games from the Briscoes earlier on, but it got downright serious when wrestling's greatest tag team struck the low blow. Coleman and Alexander go on to the win. But Nigel, the question that I have to ask is, it looks like Cedric and Caprice are even confused about how things went down. They're completely unaware. Coleman and Alexander, they have won in the Proving Ground. They've got to feel good about that.
Without a doubt. I mean, obviously, I don't think we're aware of the interference, but at the end of the day, a win is a win is a win, unless it's a win for a shot at the tag team titles.
Well, we know that there's tons of issues heading to Border Wars between wrestling's greatest tag team and the Briscoes. Our main event, the first defense for the new World Television Champion, Roderick Strong. He goes one-on-one against the red-hot Adam Cole.
And still to come, we are going to hear from wrestling's worst nightmare, Kevin Steen, as he prepares to face the Ring of Honor World Champion for that belt, Davey Richards.
But coming up next, the ROH television debut of the Man-Beast Rhino. Stay with us.
This is Veda Scott, here in the locker room with representatives of both the House of Truth and the Embassy Limited. And gentlemen, you obviously have come to some sort of agreement.
We're in the money. We're in the money. Do, 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 do. And it's all because of a product that the embassy has built and earned. Tell them about it, my friend.
The deal is done. A talent contract has been transferred from Embassy Limited to House of Truth. And we don't know why, nor do we want to. It's called plausible deniability, Your Majesty.
All right, Truth, so who is, what is this?
I have purchased a mercenary to get rid of everybody in title contention, and that man is the Man-Beast Rhino.
Tonight, I make my Ring of Honor TV debut. It doesn't matter the name of my opponent, nor do I care, because it'll be written on his toe tag. Toronto, Die Hard Eddie Edwards, you will die. A slow, painful death, and it will be hard. And right before you take your last breath, you will look across that ring as you cry tears of blood, and you will beg for me to put you out of your mercy as I rip you in half with a gore, gore, gore!
The art of the deal between the HOT and the Embassy Limited is Rhino now under the control of Prince Nana. Hey, this young man making his ROH debut. He's got the unenviable task of facing the hard-charging Rhino. Let's go to Bobby Cruz.
This match is number one of all. In the ring, wrestling out of Woolwich, Rhode Island. Weighing 185 pounds, Vinny Marsaglia.
Vinny Marsaglia, young competitor, impressed ROH officials at a trial camp in 2011. A product of Rhode Island, a talented tattoo artist and painter. Silky smooth, but brother, you better get to get.
And listen to this place. Come on, Glue. We talk about a professional wrestling legend. One of the most physically imposing athletes ever in professional wrestling is now under the control of the House of Truth. And he has one mission, Kevin. Keep Eddie Edwards out of the world title hunt to help Roderick Strong. The Man Beast makes his ROH TV debut.
Wrestling out of Detroit, Michigan. Weighing 265 pounds. He is representing the House of Truth, the Man-Beast Rhino!
Big business for Embassy Limited. And the HOT makes the deal.
This is a very exciting day for the House of Truth. I have the Ring of Honor television champion, Roderick Strong. I have the breakout star of 2012, Unbreakable Michael Elgin.
Five-star Michael Elgin.
Now I have a hired mercenary and the newest member of the House of Truth, the Man-Beast Rhino.
Yeah.
the Man-Beast movement begins tonight, because he's going to plow through all of the competition. So, Mr. Tattooed, funny-looking man.
Look who's talking.
I hope you kissed your mommy and daddy goodbye, because they're never going to see their pork juice of a son ever again, courtesy of the Gore, Gore, Gore.
Let's go to the tail of the tape, where we can see Rhino is bigger, an enormous experience advantage, and will only shake your hand if there's a $100 bill in it. This mercenary is all business, Nigel.
Absolutely. I wouldn't like to be in Vinny's shoes right now.
This is a time in every young wrestler's career where they may be having second thoughts about their chosen profession. Vinny's offering the code of honor. You can forget about it, young man. My goodness.
Mowed him down with that clothesline.
Belly-to-belly suplex.
Looks like he's setting up for it already. Listen to the people. They know it. Vinny's going to know it.
Oh! He just cut Marcelli in half with the Gore. And there goes Vinny.
The winner of the match, the Man-Beast, Rhino.
He don't get paid by the hour. Let's take a replay look at the Gore. My goodness. What will the mercenary have in store? The Man-Beast Rhino is here in Ring of Honor under the control of Truth Martini. Martini's made the deal of the century, acquiring the services of Rhino. There may be no stopping the House of Truth. Man-Beast walks the path of destruction here in ROH.
But up next, we're going to hear from Kevin Steen, who cannot wait for Border Wars May 12th. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
We're back on Ring of Honor Wrestling. I've been joined by executive producer Jim Cornette, who was asked to speak to our guest at this time. He is wrestling's worst nightmare, Kevin Steen.
Gin up some support from your home country for border wars, because I don't think you have any more respect for your country than you do for ours.
Jimmy, I don't need to do anything to get more support. I think these people like me just fine. No, what I'm doing is I'm actually carrying this flag for you to make you feel good, to make you feel at home, because you called the Toronto May 12th event Border Wars. I figured I'll bring my flag to face the American Wolf so that you can feel like it's 1997 again. Border Wars! Yeah!
Look, smart aleck, the reason that I asked you to come out here because I have something very important to talk to you about, so if you'd listen...
Yeah, you know what? That's ironic, too, because you bring me out here to talk, and I'm told you have to go out there. Jim called you. But when I was calling you for a year to talk to you about how I was kicked out, you weren't answering, were you? You were probably too busy fantasizing watching Davey Richards' matches, right?
As a matter of fact, I want to talk to you about your match with Davey Richards.
I want to talk about Davey. I noticed Davey's not here. Or is he? Your ass is so wide, I can't really see what's back there. Let me try to call him out. Aroo! No, nothing. Where is Davey Jim?
Look.
Are you gonna do all this talking? Or is he gonna stand up to me like a man? For what?
First off, I want to parlay into this, because if we're going to bring out flags, I thought, well, I might as well bring out the most important one. But everything's a big joke to you, right? Let me tell you what's not going to be a joke, Kevin. When I get you in the ring of Toronto, and I kick your fat head off all the way back across the border into America, the best country in the world, huh? I want you to bring your flag, Kevin, because I'm going to bury it with you in Toronto.
How about you shut your mouth and let me talk? This isn't about flags. That's not. You know what it's about? It's about two things. The Ring of Honor World title. And it's about me and you. You know why? Because a lot of people might not know this, but you and I used to be real close. Yeah, we wrestled all over the United States together. We've known each other for years. And I remember one thing. I remember a couple months after I was kicked out of this place, I picked you up at the airport in Montreal. Now, to listen, we drove to a show, and after you were done telling me about your life and your personal problems and Davey Richards, I told you about what bothered me, which was the way Ring of Honor screwed me. I told you about how Ring of Honor was my life. And you looked at me in the eye and you said, you know what, Kev, that's fine. I'll help you. I'll talk to Jim. They like me. I got this. And you didn't do s***. Because you didn't want me around. Because you know that Kevin Steen steals the show every time.
How ironic, Kevin. After all this time, the guy who steals the show is back, and yet still takes no responsibility. First it's El Generico, then it's Jim Cornette, now it's Davey Richards. Everyone's holding poor Kevin Steen down, right? Your biggest nightmare, your biggest problem is you. You need to take your fat ass and look in the mirror, because you're holding yourself down.
You want to talk about looking in the mirror? What do you see when you look in the mirror, huh? Do you see a hypocrite? Because that's what I see. You come out here, and after every match, after every show, you talk about how great Ring of Honor is, how it's your home, how the Ring of Honor title means the world to you. How many times have you threatened to quit? How many times have you threatened to go somewhere else? How many times have you said, Jim, I'll go back to Japan if things don't go my way? Oh, how many times?
You want to know? You want to talk about Japan, Kevin? Well, I don't want to do this in public, but looks like we're going to do it. You see, I'll admit it. People like Kevin Steen. Kevin Steen sells tickets. The problem being Ring of Honor management, and Jim Cornette knows that. He also knows you put Kevin Steen in the ring with Davey Richards, and Kevin Steen will be no more, because I will end you. In fact, Kevin, I know what you're trying to do. I know exactly what you're trying to do. So you want to get in a war of words, I gotcha. I'll tell you what, fat boy, you want war. Screw Toronto. We'll do this right now.
Wait just a minute. No, 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 no. Hey, God, no. Hey, come on. You want your title match, huh? Hold this guy back. Let me tell you something. I haven't been protecting him from you. I've been protecting you from him because he's wanted to fight you since day one, and I know what he's going to do. And I think if you were the Ring of Honor champion, it'd be the end of this company because you're an attention whore and a pig. All right? But now you've got the match. You've got what you asked for, and Davey, you don't have to quit and go to Japan because you got what you asked for. You're going to fight in Toronto, and you've gotten everything you asked for. The title's on the line, It's in your home country, and he made me allow the pile driver to be legal for this match only. You've got everything you want, but I want one thing from both of you. If the pile driver's going to be legal, the way you guys hate each other, we don't want to be sued. So I've got a waiver. And all I want both of you to do is sign this. If anybody gets their neck broke, if anybody goes to the hospital or is paralyzed, you can't sue the company. I want both of you to sign this. And then in Toronto, you can kill each other. You sign this so you can't sue me, and he's going to snap your leg.
Yeah, I'll sign it, gladly. What would I sue you for anyway? A collection of old Smoky Mountain tapes?
Oh. What is the matter with you? All right, there you go. And let me just say one more thing. As many times as you've accused me of impropriety, you should have read this. You guys just signed a waiver. If you get hurt, you can't sue me. And also, just so I don't have to deal with this anymore, you've signed an agreement. This is your one chance at the Ring of Honor Championship. You have this match. Make it good, because you'll never get another one. I said good day, gentlemen.
That's fine, Jim. Take your ass back to Kentucky before I destroy it. You know what, Damie? I'll see you in Toronto, but you mark my words. All I need to take that title is one shot.
You mark my words, fat ass. You got no shot come Toronto.
Is legal. Kevin Steen will get one shot and one shot only at Border Wars. But tonight, our main event, the first World TV title defense for new champion Roderick Strong, as he faces the red hot Adam Cole. But up next, we'll go inside Ring of Honor. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
The battle lines have been drawn for Border Wars in Toronto on May the 12th, and we'll have all the latest news here tonight inside Ring of Honor. This tremendous event from Toronto's Ted Reeve Arena features the ROH World Title matchup with the American Wolf, Davey Richards, defending against pro wrestling's worst nightmare, Kevin Steen, in the main event. The World Tag Team title is up for grabs as well in a fight without honor. Anything goes, with the Briscoe Brothers defending against Charlie Haas and Shelton Benjamin, wrestling's greatest tag team. There must be a winner. And ROH officials have stated it will be the last time these two teams will be matched up for the tag titles. And as we learned last week, Lance Storm, after his loss to Mike Bennett in Fort Lauderdale, has asked for one more chance against the Prodigy in what could be his final match in Toronto and in Ring of Honor as well.
21 years I've been doing this. 21 years I've seen it all. And Mike Bennett, in you, I see potential for greatness. But I also see potential for disaster. You don't know when to leave well enough alone. Disrespecting me in the ring during a match, I'm fine with that. I've done it myself. But what you did after that match, laying me out one more time, that was a middle finger to the fans and to the wrestling industry. It was uncalled for, and it's something you have to answer for. Because in Toronto, Canada, my home away from home, I'm going to make you answer for it. Answer for the disrespect in the ring and out of the ring. Lance Storm is not going out laying on his back with you and your two-bit girlfriend standing over me. You should have left well enough alone.
Also, in a grudge match stemming from their Showdown in the Sun interaction, former TV champion Jay Lethal faces the dominant male Tommaso Ciampa. Ciampa caused Lethal's loss of the title to Roderick Strong, and now Lethal has set his sights on ending Ciampa's year-plus-long undefeated streak.
Good things come to those who wait. It is signed, sealed, and delivered in Toronto. It is Jay Lethal versus Tommaso Ciampa. Everybody knows what happened in Fort Lauderdale. You stalked me all weekend like some sick little creep. In my match with Roderick Strong, you threw me into the steel post and then threw me in the ring, and Roderick Strong just so happened to capitalize on it. You cost me something that I hold near and dear, and that's my Ring of Honor Television Championship belt. So in Toronto, it's only fitting that I cost you something that you hold near and dear, and that's your undefeated streak, because I'm going to end it. And in Toronto, I will be the new dominant male.
Jay Lethal, did you really think in Fort Lauderdale that I was going to give you your belt back? Did you think I was going to shake your hand? Jay Lethal, did you think for 1 second that I was going to tell you that you're the better man? I don't lie. One thing I don't do is I don't lie. Since day one in this company, I've said I was going to beat everybody in front of me, and I've done it. You talk about lethal injections. Come Toronto, you're going to find out exactly what Project Ciampa is all about.
In addition, diehard Eddie Edwards will meet the challenge of the man-beast Rhino, Truth Martini's hired mercenary. The former world champion is preparing for one of the most physical matches of his career.
Rhino, you're going to yell, you're going to scream, you're going to huff and puff. You're going to try to intimidate me. Stop. Because I know what you've done. You're a scary guy. I know what you're capable of. But Rhino, you have never faced Die Hard. You have never had the Die Hard experience. Rhino, you talk about the gores. If you gore me, you are going to cut me in half. Rhino, you better hope. If you gore me, it kills me. Because in Toronto, I'm going to get back up. And I'm going to show you what Die Hard's all about.
In addition, the Belfast Bruiser, Fit Finley, one of the greatest ring technicians of our generation, goes one-on-one with Roderick Strong. And the two breakout ROH stars of 2012, Adam Cole and Unbreakable Michael Elgin, face off in a battle of speed versus strength. Tickets are on sale now, but if you can't be there live, see it as it happens anywhere in the world with internet access. Just go to ROHWrestling.com for all the info. Our Canadian fans can hear exclusive news and interviews about Border Wars on the Law, live audio wrestling, heard Sunday nights at 11 p.m. Eastern on TSN 1050 in Toronto and worldwide on LiveAudioWrestling.com. Win tickets to the event, ROH merchandise, even lunch with myself and Nigel McGuinness in Toronto on May the 12th. An event for the ages, Border Wars, live from Toronto on Saturday, May the 12th. We'll have more on this international conflict coming up next week inside Ring of Honor.
You make this a title match. You beat Roddy Strong tonight. I would give you back your belt.
You know what, Tommaso? I'll agree to your stupid little challenge. And after I beat Roderick Strong, if you don't uphold your end of the deal, I'm going to come out there, beat your ass, and take what's rightfully mine.
Capitalize on this though. Up! Oh, oh, I don't believe it!
One, two, go! And Tommaso Ciampa just flings the belt into the ring!
The new television champion!
Well, you just saw how Roderick Strong captured the world TV title at Showdown in the Sun. Tommaso Ciampa played a huge role in what happened. But can the man who owns a pinfall victory over world champion Davey Richards unseat the new TV champion? Can Adam Cole make history tonight?
That is a very, very good question, Nigel. And the tension here in the New Burns Arena after Kevin Steen just signed away his one and only opportunity at the Ring of Honor World Championship. Steen's shot at Richards will be his last. He better make it count. So tensions building. Roderick Strong, he entered Showdown of the Sun with one idea, to become the world champion on day one. He fell short on Friday. He lucked into a TV title match against Jay Lethal on day two. And now Roderick Strong makes his first defense of his newly won crown. Let's go to Bobby Cruz.
Holy Contest is your television main event. It is set for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. And it is for the Ring of Honor World Television Championship. Introducing first to my left, the challenger, wrestling out of Panama City, Florida, weighing 195 pounds, Adam Cole. His opponent to my right is being accompanied by Truth Martini. Wrestling out of Tampa, Florida, weighing even 200 pounds, he is representing the House of Truth. He is the Ring of Honor World Television Champion, Roderick Strong.
Here's the ego of a new champion. We tried to talk to him earlier today. You know what he said? Hey, Kevin, Nigel, can you make sure you tell everybody about my new T-shirt? Let's go to the tail of the tape here for our television championship match, where we can see experience is the bigger separator between these two very evenly matched athletes. Cole was a junior in high school when Roddy debuted in ROH. We know Cole adheres to the code of honor, but Strong picks his spots when it comes to showing respect.
I think I could see it here. I could see the handshake, because Roddy's arguably in the most confident stage of his career.
Well, that is very true. But Roderick Strong has
to,
and he does. So he's picked his spot here, and he adheres to the code of honor, and referee Paul Turner calls for the bell here in our championship matchup here at our main event this week. And we thank you for joining us on Ring of Honor Wrestling Television. We're counting down to Border Wars on May the 12th. We talked all about it earlier on in our Inside the Ring of Honor segment. And for the latest updates on everything related to Border Wars, go to ROHWrestling.com. Cole's out of the side headlock. Tackle by Roderick Strong. You see the agility of Adam Cole. Here's a drop down by Roderick. Catches a boot to the chest, he does. And great neck breaker. Fast way to start things off. An early pinning attempt.
Just the one count. Now, I don't think anybody even expected the two there. We talk about confidence at the beginning here. Who wouldn't be confident? You're looking at the man here, only the second ever Triple Crown winner in Ring of Honor history.
He certainly is. Eddie Edwards was the first, and Roderick Strong sends Adam Cole to the buckle. Charges in, but Cole gets the boots up. Knocks him down with an elbow off the second rope. Here's a cover, another pinning combination, this time a two.
Got a two this time, yeah.
Before Strong kicks out. But I mean, really, you want to talk about a four-leaf clover in your pocket. You go into, the weekend of Showdown in the Sun. You don't come through in the world title match on Friday. You know you've got a Blind Destiny Challenge match against Jay Lethal on Saturday, but Tommaso Ciampa basically goaded Lethal in defending the title. Put the championship on the line, he said, and I'll return the belt. Shake your hand and say you're the better man. Roddy, two, almost got the win. And of course, it was Ciampa that, as we saw, played a huge role in the outcome of that matchup.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, but you got to call it the way you see it. And the bottom line is that pride got to Jay Lethal, you know.
Well, it did, and Ciampa picked his spot for sure. Opportunistic firing out of the chair, sending Lethal into the post. As Bobby Cruz was making the time limit countdown, no one saw it, no one heard it, the damage done, and disdainfully cast the TV title belt back in. Wait a minute now, there's a lateral press. Threw the title belt back into the ring, said, here's your belt, Lethal, I'm out of here. And how much does Ciampa hate the man that he would rather see somebody else beat Lethal for the belt than to actually have to hand the belt back over himself?
No question about it.
Listen to Truth Martini, who's got to still be percolating because of what the man-beast Rhino did earlier on here in the broadcast. Strong follows in and buries a knee right to the gut of Adam Cole.
Things are looking pretty good for the House of Truth there, right, Kev?
Yeah, they got to say, things are looking up. You've also got Michael Elgin, who is the You know, he and Adam Cole, the breakout stars of 2012. But if you're investing, you buy Michael Elgin right now. That matchup with Davey Richards still has everybody talking from Showdown in the Sun, and that's a must-have for any ROH fans collection.
Without a doubt. I mean, I think that's one of the magical things about Ring of Honor, you know. Before we went into that main event, I don't think any of us had a clue just how much Michael Elgin had in his tank, you know. He stepped up, he performed on the biggest stage of the year. And that's what's just so magical about this company, that we let young guys go out there, give them the
cover
opportunity.
Two count only.
And Michael Elgin more than proved himself to
he
me.
He certainly did. He made the most of his Blind Destiny Challenge opportunity. Will Kevin Steen do the same? Steen in action here next week, ladies and gentlemen. Kevin Steen will go one-on-one against the protege of Davey Richards, Kyle O'Reilly. That's next week. Great dropkick by the new TV champ. Cover two. You know, Roderick Strong in control. I'm being told we've got to take one more commercial break. Ladies and gentlemen, this television title match will continue. We'll be back in 2 minutes. Stay with us. We're back, ladies and gentlemen. This World Television title match continues. Roderick Strong, his first title defense against Adam Cole. Things got bleak for the challenger. Roderick couldn't put him away, but Mike Dusto here, the messiah of the backbreaker, nails him. No! Cole won't stay down. Everything Roderick did during the commercial break, Nigel. Cole wouldn't stay down. The fight continued. This kid won't quit.
Certainly he won't quit, and that's what happens when you're on a run, the likes that Cole's on, you just feel as though no one can stop you. But let's be honest here, you know, and I can talk personally, when I was the champion, the first title defense I ever had, I never was that confident again, because when you've got that belt, you're on top of the world, you don't think there's somebody in the world that can beat you.
Well, Roderick Strong is going to have to face the Belfast Bruiser, Fit Finlay.
My God.
At Border Wars, and if he's teeming with confidence now, Finley's going to beat it out of him in Toronto as Cole is firing back. Fans in Charleston, fans in Columbus, Ohio, in Pittsburgh. Get ready, Ring of Honor's coming. Adam Cole's going to look to bring the TV title there. Nobody home. Knocked down with the clothesline. Challenger's cooking. Great drop kick. Lateral press. Leg is hooked. Referee in position. Two count on them.
Just a two count. Is he going to try for that Florida Key German suplex here? Or has he got something else up his sleeve? I don't know.
For all the updates on Border Wars, check out our friends with Live Audio Wrestling. Sunday nights at 11 p.m. Eastern on TSN 1050 in Toronto. And wait a minute.
Kevin, look at this.
Michael Elgin is coming down here to ringside. And that can only mean bad things for Adam Cole. Inziguri there from the challenger. Flying knee. Caught him. Got him. Tight. You know, Elgin, I was almost remiss in mentioning Elgin, conspicuous by his absence and the onset of this matchup, but now perhaps we're seeing the plan of Truth Martini come to fruition.
I guess so. I guess Truth had him stay in the back earlier on. Maybe told him to come out later on if Roddy's in trouble. I don't know.
Slingshots his way in into a roll-up. Boy, that was great. But Cole kicked out. Cole kicked out. I was just about to say that one is it. Now, Strong buries a boot right to the midsection. But a boot in response from Cole. There's an enziguri and connected Strong. Double knee gut buster. One, two, no!
Just a two count. Things moving at a pretty fast pace in this one. I don't think they're going to get to the 15-minute time limit.
We do want to say hello to all the fans tuning in all across Ring of Honor television stations throughout America, upstate New York, southern Ontario, fans gearing up for Border Wars, everybody making their plans, still some tickets remaining for the Ted Reeve Arena, but you better get them quick, because they are going to sell out. And now, Roderick Strong with the Gibson driver. Wait a minute, Cole counters out! jumping knee.
Oh, look at that, right in the head.
Shades of Strong almost beaten with a backbreaker and just that close to a new world television champion.
I nearly ate my words there, Kevin. Dropped him right on his head. Strong's in trouble.
Cole's got to find a way to follow up. Remember, Adam Cole has a pinfall victory over the world champion Davey Richards. That happened at the 10th anniversary event, the tag team main event. He's done it on the big stage before.
Oh!
Wait a minute. Cole just got elevated over the top rope and landed right on top of Unbreakable Michael Elgin, who looked like Strong may have sacrificed Elgin right there.
Trying for the knee, didn't get it, but slipped behind.
One, two. Oh, Elgin wiped out again.
For the second time, Elgin comes into play. Watch out.
Jumping in Zaguri there from the outside. Now Cole gonna look to go topside. Can he hit the crossbody? Can he pin the new world television
champion? He's hit it.
One, two, ow!
And Elgin now trying to get in the ring. Gotta be careful, this could be a DQ.
Watch out for Elgin and watch out. Wait a minute, look at Martini sneaking in from behind and the Book of Truth right across the shoulder blades. Referee never saw it.
Look at that.
One, two, three. That skunk Martini has done it again.
The winner of the match is still Ring of Honor World Television Champion, Roderick Strong.
Roderick Strong is victorious, and what a night for the House of Truth. Rhino and Roderick Strong both win big. Next week, Kevin Steen versus Kyle O'Reilly. Plus the dominant male, Tommaso Ciampa, meets Matt Taven.